Angular JS, which can also be called as Angular 1 JS and Angular 2. So what is the difference? So to answer you, I cannot compare these two. Angular JS and or Angular 1 is completely different than the Angular 2. It means the Angular 2 is completely new. It's like overwritten by Microsoft and Google. So Angular 1 and Angular 2 are completely different. In terms of Angular 1 and Angular 2 are based out of the JavaScript frameworks, but so Angular 2 is component-based framework. What do you mean by the component? So in JavaScript, you cannot declare a variable with a data type. Only thing is you can declare with var keyword, where it will implicitly get to know which data type it is. Clear? What I'm saying is, when you say I have already given it, var a equal to 10, right? Var a equal to 10 and var a equal to quote string, this one. So how will you know that it's string, and how will you know that the first one is integer? It's like a blind guess, right? So you don't have any data type. So same thing, this is in the JavaScript. In the Angular 2 framework, you can write number and you can write string. So what I mean to say is, you will have data types defined to the variables. So the way you write in the JSP, the same thing you are going to implement in the Angular 2 framework by using TypeScript. Okay, there's a new language which will be used in the Angular 2 that is called as TypeScript. TypeScript is nothing but the combination of JavaScript and any other object-oriented language. It means the way you inherit the classes in Java, the way you inherit the, chain them, like method overriding, method overloading, all this can be done in TypeScript. Now, so what is the difference between Angular JS and Angular 2? So you cannot ask this JS difference, because Angular 2 is completely overwrite of the Angular JS. Angular JS have a lot of limitations in terms of object-oriented concepts, right? So what exactly we need for the development environment? So when it comes to the development environment, we need Node.js. So it's an open source server framework, and it's free. And it runs on different platforms, like, different platforms can be used. And it also based out of JavaScript, but JavaScript on the server. So you must get a doubt, JavaScript on the server. So what do you mean by JavaScript on server? Basically, JavaScript is a client-based, right? Client-side scripting language, right? When I say JavaScript, Node.js uses JavaScript on the server. So you should get a doubt, like, how come this JavaScript on the server? So the way we develop the scripting language, JavaScripting language in the client side, like the HTML embedded, the same way Node.js framework also uses the JavaScript, but on the server side. The best example is Google Chat. So let's say when I ping you, hi, so immediately you'll get a ping, right? So that's on the server side, but without any time gap. The one platform to, like, one communication channel to other communication channel. Let's say I am from the, like, I am pinging from Google Chat from one different, like, browser. So the client side JavaScript is going to interact with the server side JavaScript. Whenever I ping you something, so the Google server, whatever the JavaScript or like any scripting language on the Google server, will always monitor for the pings. So as soon as it receives any request from other end, it will trigger the server. So basically, you don't get into that in details. It's basically Node.js uses a JavaScript on the server. When you write HTML, so the browser will understand only the HTML. What I'm saying is, and this Node.js is a server. We need, like the way you have the Apache Tomcat, right? When you write the server side pages, you need to have a server, right, to host that file. So the same way, you have Node.js to host your Angular too. That's your server. And we need to have a IDE, right? Development environment, integrated development environment. Like the way you have Eclipse for Java, we will have Visual Code, WebStorm, Visual Studio.
Okay.
So even though you are a Java background, most of the Java or any other platform guys will be using Visual Code. This is a freeware editor from the Microsoft. Imagine Microsoft is coming towards open source. It means there is something wrong with the tightly coupled softwares, right? So WebStorm is another IDE, but it is not a freeware. Excuse me. And Visual Studio is another IDE from the Microsoft, right? So we will be using Visual Code IDE to develop the Angular 2 framework, Angular 2 applications, okay?
Okay.
As WebStorm is not a freeware, and it is a JetBrains company, and Visual Studio is Microsoft, and it's not the lightweight version. So Visual Code is lightweight, and where you have a lot of features, you don't even like imagine the syntax highlighting and code refactoring, and a lot of keyboard options, keyboard shortcuts, and moreover, it is open source. So we are going to use Visual Code. So most of the companies prefer Visual Code because it's very lightweight. And obviously, browser advancement, Google Chrome or Mozilla. So when I say Google Chrome, why? You have the development environment. So when you say F12, you have all these development features, right? All your console sources, you can observe the networks, what is the performance and which page in the server it is hitting, right? Your memory, everything you can see. So how browser knows like whether you are using HTML5 or HTML? So HTML is the older version and HTML5 is a new version where you have a lot of features. You create a text box, whether it is a password type text box or it's like a placeholder. So everything you can give it, right? Like even if it is a email text box, you can give the email text box. So those features were not there in the previous HTML versions. So you have all the new versions in HTML5, right? That's what we will call it as a next generation of HTML. So okay. When you open an HTML page, you'll see this doc type, right? Doc type HTML. So this is an instruction to the web browser. The web browser doesn't understand which version of HTML you're using. So when you say this not doc type HTML, then it is HTML5, okay? Our motto is not to understand HTML5 features. I just wanted to say like this is what HTML5 is. And we already covered IDE and JavaScript. It will be embedded in HTML. So it will be denoted with the script tags. Then you'll have all your JavaScript statements, right? Functions, data types, all those. Next, coming to the NPM, Node Package Manager. So let me go with Angular 2. What exactly is Angular 2? And we'll come back to NPM again. So this is purely for the interview purpose. Okay. As I said, Angular 2 is open source and it is developed by Google. So this is just a framework, JavaScript framework, and which implemented many design patterns, which I said, like whatever you are doing in a JSP. I remember that you the first statement from you was everyone are looking for the advanced one, right? No JSP, nothing now. Why?
Yeah.
The reason being, Angular 2 is with design patterns, right? And it's an open source JavaScript framework. And whatever the things you are doing in a Java and Spring Hibernate, everything can be done in Angular 2. Still, the server side, still you can use Java, right? Most of the things will be done in the UI side, the client side. That's what the Angular 2 is, very lightweight. So the MVC pattern you can use, singleton, dependency injection, everything you can use in Angular 2. So Angular 2 was written in TypeScript. That's what, like, TypeScript is a language developed by Microsoft. So now the Angular 2 is mix of a JavaScript framework and Microsoft developed TypeScript. So basically, why TypeScript? Have you ever heard of ECMAScript? ES5, ES6, they'll say. Okay, so let me go through this. Basically, your whatever the JavaScript version we have, right? So JavaScript also will have a lot of versions. The version of JavaScript supports all the browsers, like ECMAScript, I said, right? 5. So where you have your declaration of variables without any data type. So those are the one. You cannot override a method. You cannot overload a method, right, in JavaScript. So in those were the cases used in ECMAScript 5. So it's like a traditional way of declaring variables and declaring functions, declaring methods. So in a later version of script, right, ECMA 6, ES6, I mean, don't get into in details because this is not going to be useful because it's completely browser side languages. So the browser currently, like, browser understand JavaScript and HTML, right? So the current version of JavaScript will understand, like, will be in ES6. So the main, as a developer, you should understand is ES5 and ES6. These are the versions actually, right? So ES5 is the one, like, which were not having any object oriented concepts. And the ES6 came up with a object-oriented concepts, like the way you can create an object in Java or C#, you can create in ES6. The way you can declare a variable, like with the data types, that you can do in ES6. You can create class, you can overwrite class, you can override class, right? You can inherit, you can use polymorphism, right? Whatever the object-oriented concept that you use in your server-side languages, that can be used in ES6. So ES6 also called as ES2015. You can use arrays, you can use anything like generics, collections. In your advanced Java, you have it, right? You can create dynamic arrays, right? You can use generics, you can use templates, what more? So TypeScript is a combination of JavaScript, okay? JavaScript and ES5, ES6. So basically, when you write TypeScript, browser cannot understand it, correct? Because browser can understand only .html and .js files. So TypeScript comes with a extension .ts, okay? When you write any HTML file, the extension would be .html. When you write a JavaScript file, extension would be .js. So the same way, you will have the extension as .ts. It means TypeScript, okay? Okay, so we need, like, the browser doesn't understand what is TypeScript. So in TypeScript, you can have class-based and object-oriented. As I just said that, you can write classes, you can inherit the classes, you can do whatever the object-oriented language does, clear? And you can also use strongly typed. Strongly typed is explicitly saying that, hey, this variable is int type. Hey, this variable is string type. This variable is decimal. This variable is float. So there are few data types involved in the TypeScript. So that can be that can be used in the TypeScript. So the only challenge now is the browser doesn't understand .ts extension files, right? That's where the transpilation came into picture. So that's the main reason of like using TypeScript. TypeScript will have the compiler, TypeScript compiler. So you have the Java compiler, right? So the same way you'll have the TypeScript compiler. You will call it as TSC. And TSC, TypeScript compiler, will be used to compile your JavaScript, your TypeScript files to JavaScript. So I think if you are a Java developer, so you might know like how the compiler will work, right? The .jsp file, it will compile and it will, so when you compile, your server will understand that, right? So the same way browser should understand your TypeScript language, right? When you write, when you declare a class, so your browser doesn't understand class, and your browser doesn't understand .ts file. So your browser needs a JS. So TypeScript compiler will compile your TypeScript to JS. That is called as transpilation. Okay, when you say compilation, the same way transpilation. So basically when you in the IDE, in the Visual Code IDE, you will create a .ts file. So when you compile it, right, TSC, when you attempt, what you call TypeScript compiler runs, so it will transpile your TS file to JS file. So let's say you have written a test.ts file and you run your transpiler, so it will convert as test.js. So your browser will take test.js into consideration, not the TS file. Yeah. That's about the TypeScript. So have you understand what exactly is TypeScript? What exactly is Angular 2? So what is the importance of TypeScript in Angular 2? So let me recap it. Angular 2 is a framework, a JavaScript framework, which will be written in TypeScript language. So latest version of JavaScript will have the classes and all object-oriented concepts involved. So that's where TypeScript came into picture. TypeScript has the data type, strongly typed features, object-oriented features, class-based classes you can create. You can use all your object-oriented features like encapsulation, polymorphism, multiple inheritance, right? Interfaces, basically. And what more? Like the way you write in JSP or C#, any other object-oriented languages, the same way you can write in the TypeScript language. So as your browser doesn't understand the TypeScript, you need to transpile it to .js. So the TypeScript compiler will take care of it. Now, let's not go into the theoretical part. Let me show you that in the Visual Code tomorrow. Okay, so compiling values. As I said, you know, when you say var x declare in JavaScript, and when you say x equal to 40 and x equal to hyd, right? So you can assign anything, right? So this is not like you can call it as a loosely typed language, right? You dynamically you can change the values. That's not a good practice, correct? So when you create, your browser get confused. That's the reason. When you write JavaScript, so most of the JavaScript functions will fail in the browsers. Probably you'll get compatible issues, you'll get the like backward compatibility. So since JavaScript is loosely typed language, it allows whenever you want to change a value of a variable, it will allow, which is not a good practice. So in the TypeScript, when you say number X, so you can assign only number values, right? So this is like explicitly you are saying to the browser that I am going to use this variable, especially for your integer variables. It's called as like memory allocation of the variable, like memory will be created and all, right? When you say this without a data type, when you create a variable, it will not allocate a space. you know, your memory usage will be more. So in the TypeScript, you have this feature, like feature of explicitly usage of data types. Correct. So this is the syntax of the TypeScript. Like when you going like with the working project, you'll understand. Like, so let's say I have given a variable A. You can also say that var A with a colon string. So this is a syntax in the TypeScript, and A can be assigned only with the integer, like with the string values, as it is defined as a string. So when I say A equal to 40, I'll get into error. So as I said, JavaScript with the data types is nothing but a TypeScript. Okay. So when you write your myscript.ts in a TypeScript language, it will transpile by using the transpiler into myscript.js, which is understandable by your browser. So now I'm expecting a question from you. So to develop this, what exactly I need in my mission? Correct? You need the IDE, and you also need to download Node.js, which is what I said. Node.js is a open source server framework. Okay. So let me write down here. I think I cannot write. I'm not done. Oh, okay. So you need Visual Code IDE, and you need your Node.js, and you see whether if your mission is 32-bit or 64-bit based on your mission configuration, you download it. So once you install that, what you can do is, okay, that's it. I mean, we need only the environment to set up is Node.js and Visual Code. Visual Code is to develop your Angular 2 components, and Node.js is to run your Angular 2 application. Clear? And you also need to install TypeScript. Of course, let me TypeScript. So I think that's fine. You don't need to install TypeScript. You know, when you use Visual Studio, you need the TypeScript. Okay. So Node.js and your so latest version of Node.js you install. That is 6.11 and Visual Code. So once, let me in roughly in 10 minutes, let me show you this Visual Code and Angular 2 framework and Angular 2 code. So once you install your Node.js, what you can do is you can see your Node version. So you open command prompt, or else you can right now you can install it, right? You can give it for installation. I just wanted to show a sample Angular 2 quick start. So let's start with you know, let's assume that you have installed your Node.js and your Visual Code. So once you have installed your Node.js, Node.js installation would be as easy as the other softwares that you install in Windows. So once you install, you go to command prompt. Okay. And you see that node, right? You node minus V. It means you wanted to see the node version that is installed in your mission. So when you see this V6, like anything, whatever the version, I have installed version 6.10, but the latest version is 6.11. 6.11, right? So whichever, I mean, whatever is the fine, like you can use any one of the node versions. That's about it. And also you can check for the npm. So node also install your npm. So I forgot to say about npm, right? Okay. So npm is a package manager. When you wanted to set up your Angular 2, right? So it's like a node. It's a package manager from the node side. So when you install Node.js, it it comes with Node Package Manager. Okay, so Node Package Manager will ease your tasks actually. So it's a package manager where you can install your packages. So let me explain you package in tomorrow's class. What is package actually? So package.json is a configuration file. When you create a project, it will be created inside your project. Like the way you will have the application configuration files, right? Your server side. So the same way, you'll have your package.json, which is a configuration file, like what to install, what not to install, right? To install those, you need an NPM, Node Package Manager. I was saying the Node Package Manager comes along with your Node.js server framework. So this is mainly useful for your installation of your package configurations and all. So which version of TypeScript you wanted to use it for your project, which version of Angular you wanted to use it for your project. So those things will be mentioned in the package.json configuration file, and which will be installed by your Node Package Manager. So once you install your Node.js, it also have the NPM. So you can check the NPM version here. NPM space minus V. So it gives your Node Package Manager version, right? And also TypeScript also will be installed with your Node.js. So that can also be checked by using the command TSC minus V. So next thing is, the very next step is like you wanted to have a sample quick start. So Angular website is angular.io. So where you'll have all your documents and all like related to Angular to documents, where you'll have the, they prefer to go with the quick start, like where they have a template, like folder structure and all of the project. So a sample structure, like I'm not very much sure about the Eclipse IDE. When you create a new project in JSP, will it create a JSP page or something? Any default JSPs and all? In Eclipse Editor, when you create a new project, like a template, so will be created, right? A template. I'm not sure about the Eclipse or and Java, but in Microsoft Visual Studio, when you say to create a new project, it will ask you which type of project you want. For Angular 2, we will be using a quick start document from the Angular official website. Okay, so quick start is nothing but it will be a template for your Angular 2 framework. Okay, so what you can do is a quick start documents we need to download from the Angular 2. So you Google quick start Angular 2 download. So there's a open source versioning control that is GitHub. You might aware of this, right? GitHub is a versioning control, the way you will use SVN and Team Foundation Server, TFS, the same way you'll have the open source GitHub. So yes, there is a quick start documents where you can clone or download. So you download it. I have already downloaded and so this is a quick start. When you extract that file, so you will have all the folders created. So all this, like as I said, when you create a new Java project or .NET project, you'll have the template, right? So the same way, you have a quick start from the Angular official website called angular.io. So for what and all, you have understand, like you to set up the development environment, you need Node.js, and you need TypeScript, you need NPM, which comes along with the Node.js, and you need Visual Code. And also you need a quick start documents, right? Now, we'll finish in 2 minutes. Let me open that quick start documents, which I already created. I already opened in the Visual Code. So to open a new folder, like existing folder, you can click on open folder. It will go to that location The way you open in like Notepad, file, new, open, so the same features will be available in the Visual Code. So I have created, I have just opened the folder which I have downloaded in Angular IO website. So just before I was saying about the package.js, right? So package.js will have all your configurations. So build type, it should be TSC, TypeScript compiler. So you don't need to get into much into this because it's all about the configuration of your project. So it's one time setup. Okay. So Angular, which version you wanted to use it? 4. If you say 2, and if you install this, it will be using your Angular 2 framework. So down the line, I'm going to explain much about this folder structure, like how the source, what is app, what exactly index.html contains, what is main.ts, right? What is the configuration.js, JSON. So all this I'm going to explain you. But for now, this is the folder structure. And as soon as you open a project here, what you have to do is you go to the folder directory, quick, okay. Where I have downloaded, like where am I open in the Visual Code. So you go to that folder and you press shift and right click. You will see the option open command window here.
Okay.
Shift right click, open command window here. It means it's as simple as that. When you open a CMD here, right?
Yes.
It will open from my like users, Bharat Patwari and all. So I wanted to go from the folder, this folder only. So there is an option in the Windows, shift right click, open command command prompt here. So whatever the commands you perform, that will be installed in the current location. Clear?
Okay. Yeah.
This is not a new thing. It's like one of the shortcuts.
Yes.
Okay. So as you install NPM, Node Package Manager, so the first thing is to install your configurations to the project. When you say configurations, you have your package.json, right? Where is that? You have your package.json. As I said, package.json will have all your configurations to the project. So how will you install these configurations to your project? That is using your NPM, now Node Package Manager space install. So when you say NPM install, this is a command to install your configurations to the project. So this is just a quick start, right? So NPM install, when you enter it, takes little time, 1 or 2 minutes, 1 minute hardly, and it will install all your configurations. All your configurations, router, so that we are going to already install NPM install. Let's assume that I have installed. As soon as you install, your Quick Master will have node modules. So when you install, all these node modules will be installed. So once you perform the NPM install command, you'll see all these node modules install as per your configuration. Once that is installed, so you want to see your application in the browser. So you are going to start your application. You're going to start your node. So that the command used to start your Node Package Manager is NPM start.
Okay.
So it will host in your local host with the port 3000. So the way your Java compiles build, the same thing will happen here also. It will build, right? The Node Package Manager run the build, your TypeScript compiler will transpile, and your server is NPM, comes with a light server. Okay. So it opened our website with the localhost 3000. So this is about, so you could see your hello Angular, right? So this is the website that comes in your quick start. So let's see now. Anyway, I'll continue tomorrow then.